Okay, so getting into ketosis and staying in ketosis is different than how much energy you're actually using in your day. And I want to talk about why those differences are important for us to understand. Hello everyone, welcome to Mind Blowing Health and Wellness with Violet. The reason I make these videos is to help you to understand that your mental health and physical health come together to create your overall sense of well-being. If you find these types of videos helpful, please subscribe and ring the bell so you know my next video is coming out. Body gets into ketosis when there aren't excess carbs to process. This is usually when you've eaten 20 grams of carbs or less. Now that's a piece of information that's really important to understand if you're actually trying to successfully do a ketogenic lifestyle. Now, how you will apply this to your life really will depend on whether you're seeing keto as a long-term solution for your health or you're seeing keto as a way to lose weight. When I see keto as a way to manage my health long term, there's one really important thing that I'm going to be doing that someone that's looking at keto as a diet isn't doing. And that's finding ways to eat those 20 grams of carbs or less that I enjoy. So what does that mean? That means that I'm going to start evaluating the amount of carbs in most of the things that I eat, but then B, I'm going to start finding vegetables that I actually like, so recipes for vegetables, so cook them in ways that are tasty to me, so that I will enjoy eating these foods long into the future. Versus, if I'm looking at this ketogenic life, well, not a lifestyle, this ketogenic diet thing as something that I'm doing to lose weight in the next few months, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to choke down whatever vegetables are low glycemic. And it doesn't matter if they taste good because I'm not doing this forever. And that's a huge mistake. The things that we do to get into ketosis and the things that will keep us in ketosis are important, especially if we're going to be doing this for long term. Now, there's another thing that someone who's looking at keto as a long-term lifestyle versus someone who's looking at keto as a diet is likely doing differently. See, looking at keto from a long-term lifestyle point of view, I was never concerned about how many calories I was eating because it was irrelevant. Because, first of all, I was aware that when you bring your calorie count down, so the amount of energy that your body is using, because your body doesn't understand calories, that amount of energy that your body is using down, your body, because it's very focused on homeostasis, will adjust the amount of energy you put out to match the amount of energy you're taking in. This takes about 6 months. So when I was doing my ketogenic lifestyle, I made a point of trying to keep the amount of energy that I was actually eating about the same. So there was no reduction in calories for me. If we imagine that I was eating 2,200 calories before I started keto, I was eating somewhere around 2,000, 2,050 calories while I was doing keto. Why? First of all, it's harder to eat that much energy from fat, so it was harder to keep it exactly what it was. But also, it was about eating to satiation, making sure that my body had the energy to use to be able to do whatever it normally did. And that meant that I would eat until I wasn't hungry anymore because my body knows how much energy it typically needs. So as soon as we make that transition from eating carbs to eating fat for fuel, so when we're adapted, then our body naturally starts to balance out and try to get the amount of energy that it's needing. And if I just let myself eat that, I'm fine. Now, how do we stay in a ketogenic state? Again, understanding what's happening in our body will help us to stay in a ketogenic state. There's a certain amount of protein that I need to eat in order for my body to be able to build itself, rebuild itself, repair itself, do all the body work to keep me healthy. That amount of protein does not change whether I'm doing the standard American diet or ketogenic lifestyle. So when I do a standard American diet, I was eating, for example, one chicken leg, thigh, and drumstick. On a ketogenic lifestyle, I eat the same amount, one chicken leg, thigh, and drumstick. When I was eating a pork chop, it was about 5 to 7 ounces on the standard American diet, and it's still 5 to 7 ounces on a ketogenic diet, depending on how hungry I happen to be. The only difference between the two is that now that I'm doing the ketogenic lifestyle, I will actually allow myself to eat the fat that's on that pork chop. On the standard American diet, standard Canadian diet, I was eating poor quality oils. I allowed canola oil. I allowed vegetable oil. I didn't understand that these were bad for me. On the ketogenic lifestyle, I use coconut oil, I use avocado oil, I use olive oil, and I'm feeling much more healthy because I don't have the inflammation that was being caused by those negative oils. But I need to understand something. The oils and the protein are not what keeps me in ketosis. The oils and the protein allow me to build the best quality body that I can. The only thing that keeps me in ketosis is eating low carb, 20 grams of carbs or less. Now here's the thing, and let's be very clear. I could keep eating those great proteins and that same amount. I could keep eating high quality oils. And as soon as I reintroduce 50 grams of carbs into my life per day, I will be kicked out of ketosis. Why? Because it's the act of eating less than 20 grams of carbs per day that keeps me in ketosis. And if I get kicked out of ketosis, which isn't a big deal if it happens once, but if it's happening repeatedly, what happens is that my insulin levels are being affected, which means that my body is storing fat, which means that all of those metabolic issues that I was trying to solve will now be re-emerging. Here's the thing that I need you to keep in mind. The amount of energy that I eat is not what keeps me in ketosis. It's the amount of energy that I eat from carbohydrates that determines whether I stay in ketosis. If I eat all of my energy from a fat source, I can be in a ketogenic state. So if I do carnivore and I keep my protein moderate, I can be in a ketogenic state. If I overeat my fats while I'm doing carnivore, I can still gain weight. Let's be clear on that. Anytime you overeat any energy source, of course you will gain weight because you've overeaten it, which means that you ate more than you needed. But I will be gaining weight, yet still in a ketogenic state. I'm saying this out loud because I want people to understand that eating high fat is not the reason you're in a ketogenic state. So many times I meet people who tell me that they're doing keto, but really all they've done is raise the amount of fat they're ingesting. Sometimes they're still eating too many carbs, so they're gaining. But on other occasions, although their carbs are really low, they're still gaining because they're eating too much fat. Overeating fat, eating MCT oil, eating coconut oil, like putting butter in your coffee, like these things are not making you get into a ketogenic state. What they're doing is they're giving you energy. It's not the same thing. As long as your carbohydrate intake is 20 grams or less per day, you're likely in a ketogenic state. There are those few people that need to be 15 grams or less, or even 10 grams or less, or even carnivore. Those are the people that have metabolic issues. But outside of that story, as long as you are eating less carbs, you are going to be in a ketogenic state. The energy, so how much energy you're ingesting is about moving your body. It's about building your, having the energy to build your body, having the ability to build muscle and do what you want to do. Energy. So let's be careful and let's separate those two things, because I do want you to understand that there is a difference between getting into ketosis, staying in ketosis, and how much energy your body needs to function. You can have enough energy to function in a ketogenic state. You can have enough energy to function in a standard American diet, not ketogenic state. But in that state, your body is not functioning optimally. In a ketogenic state, it is. So let's not worry so much about eating high fat. Let's not worry so much about eating high protein. These are not the things that are helping you to stay in a ketogenic state. The only real thing you need to pay attention to if you're trying to stay in a ketogenic state is keeping your carbohydrate intake low. I'm really curious to know if any of you guys have ever been in the situation where you felt you were overeating your fats, or maybe even undereating your fats while you were trying to get fat adapted or get your body into the ketogenic state. Was fat something that you were not sure what to do with? Leave that in the comments below. For everyone who made it this far into the video, I want to let you know that I do have a Patreon account. You can contribute to the production of future videos by going to patreon.com/violetrivera. For all my wellness warriors that are here, I love seeing you. Thank you for coming by. And for everyone else who's new, please take a moment, subscribe, ring the bell so you know when my next video is coming out. I make videos every single week. And I'd love to see you here. I want to thank everyone for watching Mind Blowing Health and Wellness with Violet. And I can't wait to talk to you guys again next week. Have a great day.